Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again, and hoping the grace and the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. We are still in the season of the festive holidays, and we are coming out of celebrating the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is the rebirth of his existence in this dimension. And I explained many influences that are behind the Christmas celebration, which are designed to defile that very day, which was celebrated on the 25th of December. And today, I want to continue addressing the dark season of December. And today, I want to talk about peer pressure. Peer pressure, which is bad influence. And hoping those that have been listening to the Revelator 2022 sermons, you are going to continue throughout up until the last day and the last presentation of the Revelator 2022 sermons, which is on 31 December, on the chaotic crossover, where I shall give you the last presentation, which shall guide us into the year of 2023. Today, I want to talk about the peer pressure, bad influence. But let us get into scriptures. In the book of Luke chapter 15, verse 1. Then drew near unto him all the publicans and sinners for them to hear what he was preaching. And the Pharisees and the scribes murmured, saying, This man receives sinners and eats with the sinners. And he spake this parable unto them, saying, Now, Jesus gave them different parables after they started complaining, after they started accusing him of eating and drinking with sinners. Why? Because they did not want the sinners also to have that grace. There are Christians that behave as if they are more holy than others. And when you come across that category of Christians, they want to self-proclaim righteousness as if it is theirs personally, and not knowing that this is not righteousness, but this is developed into some form of hypocrisy. And the Pharisees, they themselves, they were hypocritical sinners, and they practiced the fake righteousness. And they were against the fact that Jesus was dining with sinners and was accommodating the sinners for the sake of salvation. And Jesus then gave them a parable. And he said, A certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that fall unto me. And he divided unto them his living. Now, this father that had two sons, he had raised his two sons hoping that the investments that he had made for his two sons, it was going to benefit his two sons at a certain later time, probably at that very time when his soul would have departed from his body and his sons would have investments. For the father was investing in both his sons all his life. And it so happens that one of the sons decided that he must get his own portion. Now, I want to get you into certain details which are not scripturally evident, but they are evident in the realms of revelation. What could have pushed this young man, who is one of the sons, to feel that he must get a portion of his inheritance before the actual time which had been planned and predetermined by the father? There are many things which God has promised you as a Christian. There are many things which God has promised you as a child of God. There are many things which God has promised you as a disciple. But you reach a point where you feel like God is delaying. You reach a point where you feel like God is forsaking you. You reach a point where you feel like God is not answering your prayers. And whilst we are in this season, which is the season where many Christians are backsliding, they are backsliding because they are feeling hopeless inside. When you are feeling hopeless inside, you backslide because of peer pressure. This young man is being driven by peer pressure that cannot be seen physically by his father. All the father is now hearing from his son is the son demanding a portion of his inheritance. But the father cannot see that there is a peer pressure that is behind the son. And that peer pressure is being inspired by bad influence. And the bad influence that is behind is bad influence that is demonic. And the demonic influence has got custodians of people that are influencing this man. That your father is robbing you. You have been working for your father for a very long time, but you have got nothing out of this. The bad influence is the thought that comes inside your mind that tells you that you have been worshiping God for a very long time, but why haven't you got anything that is tangible? This is the voice that fights many Christians. This is the voice that fights many Christians. Many Christians are struggling in their worship devotion. Many Christians are listening to that voice, the peer pressure, the bad influence, the bad demonic influence of various voices from the underworld, various voices from demonic forces, various voices that come to lure their minds, and they fall into sin. You don't fall into sin because you are weak. You fall into sin because you are listening to various voices that are unnecessary. And this young man stood before his father and said, "Father, I've worked for you for many years now. I'm not seeing where this is going." He even spoke on behalf of his brother and said, "Father, me and my brother have been working for you for many years now. And you have always told us that all this belongs to us. But I'm not seeing how this belongs to us because you are here, you are in charge. I need a portion of my inheritance so that I can go and start my own business. I can go and start my own life." As he was speaking, the father was pained. Why? Because this is the father. As God in heaven is watching his children backsliding, God feels so pained. He knows that his children have not yet put much trust in him. The father in heaven felt very pained watching Christians drinking, watching Christians backsliding, watching Christians fornicating. And the father knows that these children are backsliding because of peer pressure. They are being influenced by demons. There are Christians who backslide every December when a certain relative visits them, and they sleep the whole night drinking. There are Christians that backslide every December when they travel during the holidays. There are Christians that backslide every time they visit rich families. You start undermining your own influence. Instead of you delivering the word to those who need the word, or changing those that you are supposed to convert with the word, they end up converting you and you join them. And the son said, Father, just give me the portion of goods that fall to me. And the father had no choice. He divided unto them his living. And not so many days after the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a faraway country. And there he wasted his substance in careless, righteous living. You know what happens? When you are given the opportunity to travel and to spend money before you receive Christ, there is a spirit that accompanies you. There is a spirit that influences you. It carries you in the spirit and it makes you travel to those places of your own destruction. This is why you realize that if Lucifer wants you to sin, sometimes he has to change you to leave the environment where you are and you go to a certain favorable place which has got people that can influence you to change your motives, to change your principles, to forsake your standards. And it doesn't mean that you are going to sin the very day that you arrive in that city. It doesn't mean that you are going to sin the very day you arrive in that place. No. This young man has traveled. And when he's traveling, he's saying, I'm traveling so that I can go far away from the father with his strict rules. I'm traveling so that I can find my own liberty. I'm traveling so that I can find my own freedom, where I can be civilized. I'm tired of praying and fasting and there are no results. It's time for me to find my own purpose. And he travels and he goes very far away. I'm tired of being told this and that of the things of the spirit by the revelator, being given spiritual nuggets, being told spiritual advice. I now need to lead my own life in the way that I want. And he traveled and he went very far away from the presence of the Lord. When he arrived there, he met a certain classification, a category of personalities that were designed to lower his mind. There is a community, there is a territory, there is a place which God is expecting you to preach the gospel until you change that community. Why? Because God knows that if you don't preach until you change that community, if you don't preach until you change the family around you, the society around you, the friends around you, the relatives around you, they are going to change you. And this young man has arrived and he meets a certain type of personalities. And within days, they managed to influence him with a bad influence. And he started drinking. One that had stopped drinking for 5 years, he started drinking. And do you know that every time when a Christian backslides, there has to be someone that attacks his psychology? You don't backslide because of a practical device. You backslide because someone has dealt with your psychology spiritually. They have to impart a certain false theory that makes you feel powerless, that makes you lose hope, and then you backslide. And there were probably 3 to 4 men, 3 to 4 women that were around him. And remember, he has got money. So what it means is that even the money that he now has is no longer under the protection of the father, who was protecting him all along. And Lucifer is now ready to use that money to fund the bad influence. Meaning that when he arrived, he slept in the most expensive hotel. And he's forgetting that he's sleeping in the most expensive hotel. Why? Because the father has been safeguarding his wealth. The father has been investing in him. And he slept in the most expensive hotels. booking in the most nice places, sleeping with the most expensive harlots. You are denying that they are most expensive harlots. It's because you don't know. There are expensive prostitutes out there. They're expensive because they are designed to be expensive so that they take all that a man has worked for. And he slept with the most expensive prostitutes. He lived the life of a king in a few days. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in that land, and he began to be in want. This is the part that this young man never dreamt of, that there was going to be a famine. This is the part which every Christian, when he backslides or when he is enjoying the pleasures of the world, he forgets that this is just for a season. Right now I'm talking about the dark season of December, where many Christians have been drinking, when many Christians have forgotten that they have a faith that they need to continue abiding. They are forgetting that this is just a season which is passing by. This young man, this is exactly what he forgot when he was allowing peer pressure to influence him. He was forgetting that this was just a season, and the money that he had was going to be spent. He was forgetting that the people that were around him, they were going to depart very soon. He began realizing that he was now running out of money. But there is one thing that he had already lost. He had already lost his father. He had already lost a relationship that was valuable, which was more precious than the money that he was now realizing that he had lost a lot of money. And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country. This is the party where the devil makes sure that now I've taken everything from you. You no longer have any influence of your own kind. He now joined the citizen of that country. When you join the citizen of any country, it means peer pressure is now swallowing you. Peer pressure reaches a level where it swallows you. When you join a certain section, when you join a certain category, when you join a certain society, when you join a certain community, when you join a certain citizen of that country, you are joining a certain classification of personalities. He joined the citizen of that country. It means peer pressure is influence is a certain process where the demons actually give you time to give in. This is why you realize that you can be lasting for something for even 3 months before you fall into that sin. It takes a process to bring a Christian down for demons, like the intoxication process, how a drug hits one, and the intoxication will be increasing at every stage. And this is how this young man was brought down, and finally he was now worthless, and he was joined to the citizen of that nation. He's no longer a Christian. Is now in the world. This is the part where the scripture says, and the last state of that man becomes worse than the first. And he became very miserable, to the level that he filled his belly with the husk that the swine was eating, and no man gave unto him. Those same men that used to think that he was rich, those same men that used to respect him, they had departed away from him. Those friends that used to bring him nice, good-looking women, they had gone, and all the women, they had finished with him. And when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father's have bread enough to spare, and I perish with hunger. This is the thought that comes to every Christian after he has backslidden. He starts to remember those days that he used to pray and fast. You begin to remember that I had a mentor who used to pray for me. I had a mentor who used to wake up every morning to just give me the word. You start to remember that there is the revelator who used to bother me every morning with his sermons, and by then I thought he was bothering me. But now I realize that he was giving me life through Jesus Christ. And he started to imagine of the servants that were merely hired. He now has a poverty mentality of thinking about the level of being a servant when he was above the servants. When the Father had given him a royal status, that is what happens. When peer pressure is finished with you, you started thinking of the petty things. You started thinking of lower levels, which are less than the capacity that you are being given, the capacity which Jesus was planning for you. The royal status which Jesus wanted to give you, the devil has taken that away from you mentally. And he said unto himself, I will arise and go unto my father and tell my father that I have sinned against heaven and before you. There are Christians that think that you only sin against the Father that is in heaven. This young man understands that he has sinned also against his own mentor. There's a level you sin against your own mentor. And you're busy asking yourself, is my mentor Jesus? He's not Jesus. But he has been given the capacity, he has been given the responsibility over you. To the level that if he forsakes you, demons start attacking you. You don't like that. I know. But it's a reality. Because you've told yourself that I belong to Jesus. You have told yourself that only Jesus is in control of my life. Really? If Jesus is in control of your life, why didn't he come directly to you when you were in the world? Why didn't he descend down here? Jesus has given certain men responsibilities over certain men. And it's not even the code of spiritual fatherhood of worshipping men. It's the code of obedience. It's the code of inside the body of Christ. And this man went back to his father. When he went back to his father, he arrived and said, I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me as one of your hired servants. He went back to church and sat at the back of the church, one that used to sit in the front. He was given the back seat. He gave himself a back seat. Do you know what happens when sin is finally entered you after peer pressure has defeated you? It doesn't allow you to see your worth anymore. You'll be repenting every day. When sin is eating you inside, it makes you live in regret. And he arose and came to his father. But when his father saw him from a distance, he had compassion. Why? Because this is the Lord Father. And he ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in your sight. And in your sight, this is what disciples don't want to hear. This is what the congregation doesn't want to hear. This is what the body of Christ doesn't want to hear. They want to reduce a mentor. They want to reduce one that God has sent. They only want to focus on Jesus. They don't want to focus on one that Jesus sent. Stop lying to yourself. And he said, I am no longer worthy to be called thy son. But the father said to his servants, bring forth the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and his shoes. And bring a fat calf so that we may eat and be merry and celebrate that my son was dead and now he is alive. And they began to celebrate. Now the elder son who never left the church, the elder son who says, I'm the one that joined this church when this church was struggling. Now the elder son, who represents the Christian that never sinned, who represents the Christian who has always been devoted, did not understand this thing. He did not understand salvation. He did not understand why one that was in the world is being given a reception better than me, who has been serving for years. He did not understand that salvation. Now the elder son was in the field and he came near to the house and he heard music and the dancing. And he called one of the servants and said, "What is the meaning of all this?" And he said unto him, "Your brother is back, and your father actually killed a fat calf that he has not killed for ages now, because he had received your younger brother, and he was angry and would not go in. Therefore came his father out and entreated him, and answering him, he said unto him, all these many years you have saved me, neither transgressed. I at any time have you gone against my commandments. You have always been loyal, and yet you have not given me," as the son spoke now, "yet you have not given me anything that proves my loyalty." This is how a Christian that has never backslidden feels like. This is how a Christian that has always been in church feels like. He does not see the prize that he is. The fact that you have been in church and you have never suffered any peer pressure, you have never backslidden, you have never been influenced by bad company, you are no longer seeing the weight. Why? Because you are in the presence. The one that now understands the presence is the one that is backslidden, who's coming back. He has seen how the world is acting. He has seen how the world has been treating him. And this elder son does not understand. So I've been working, I've been serving God all this time, and this is what I get. He wants to be applauded. He wants to be paid. He wants to be rewarded for serving God, while God has already awarded him with righteousness, loyalty, and commitment. He doesn't see his prize. He believes that the worthiness of the prize should be celebrated in the same way that his young brother is being received. Child of God, I'm here to pray for you. I'm here to safeguard you with the word. I'm here to give you hope. If you are feeling hopeless, you have backslidden again and again, you have been committing one and the same sin. Yes, you go to church, but you are still committing sin. Every season, when you enter that season, you know that you are committing sin. Not because you want to commit that sin. You are surrounded by bad company. You are surrounded by bad influence. And I'm here to pray for you so that you can receive the strength of the Holy Spirit. You can receive the power of the Holy Spirit so that you can be able to have willpower. You can be able to stand firm and be the light of the world, and not allow anyone to influence you, and not allow any temporal pleasures of this world to influence you into darkness. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for your children to be strengthened, by the word, to be strengthened by your Spirit, the Spirit of truth, that makes them bold enough to be custodians of salvations, in the name of Jesus.
This is the end. This is my day. This is my.